Hello friends, this is Dr. Ritika Gauba, your PhD coach, mentor and guide. As many of you would already know, as a PhD coach, I take up personalized and one-to-one mentorship and guidance session with PhD aspirants as well as with students who are pursuing their PhD. As a PhD coach, I got an opportunity to mentor and guide many students who are preparing themselves exclusively for the PhD program of Indian Institute of Management. While interacting with all the IIMs PhD aspirants, I realized that there are certain set of questions which are being repeatedly asked by all of them. I collected these questions and decided to address them in a single video for the benefit of all future PhD aspirants. So today's video, I'm going to tell you about 9 facts related to IIM's PhD. So let us start with fact number 1. There are 20 IIMs in India and all of them offer a PhD program. These 20 IIMs are spread across the length and breadth of the country. And the first 2 IIMs to be established in India were IIMs Calcutta and IIMs Ahmedabad, which were established in the year 1961. The last or the youngest amongst all these 20 IIMs is IIMs Jammu, which was established in the year 2016. Zenith PhD has created a special table to empower you with more PhD knowledge. In this table, as you can see on the screen, we've listed all the names of all the 20 IIMs, the states in which they are located and also the region in which they are located. So from the table you can see the majority IIMs are located in the northern region, followed by east, south and west and central are almost equal. With great certainty I can tell you that as of March 2022, all of these IIMs are offering a PhD. Moving on to fact number 2. CAT is not a mandatory requirement to pursue a PhD from IIMs. CAT, or the Common Admission Test as we all know, is an exam which is collectively conducted by all the IIMs for the selection of the PG or the postgraduate students. Probably because CAT is such a reputed exam and is conducted by IIMs, students feel that CAT is also a mandatory requirement for PhD. But that is not true. Yes, CAT is an accepted eligibility exam and it is accepted by all the IIMs, but it is not the only eligibility score which is accepted by IIMs. Besides CAT, if in case you've not been able to give the exam for any reason, you can give GRE, you can give GATE, you can give GMAT, UGC NET, CSIR NET and alike. In fact, currently there are many IIMs who are also conducting their own eligibility exams. So you have many exams to choose from and not only CAT. From this, we move on to our point number 3. IIMs grant you a degree, a PhD degree. In 2017, IIMs was given the status of Institution of National Importance. An act which was known as the Indian Institute of Management Act was passed in 2017 by the HRD Ministry, which is now known as the Ministry of Education. This, after passing of this act, all the IIMs came to be known as the Institution of National Importance and hence they can now award a degree. So what happens if you do a PhD and you get a degree instead of a diploma, you can prefix the word doctor in front of your name. So with almost all the IIMs now are granting a PhD degree and not a diploma. From here, we move on to our fact number 4, which is that BTechs and similar graduates can apply to the PhD program of IIMs. Yes. Most of the people don't believe me when I tell them this, but please do believe me because I'm already guiding BTechs who are in fact going to appear for the Viva of certain IIMs as well. So BTechs and all the 20 IIMs allow this. So BTechs and any similar graduates who've done a similar 4-year, 5-year graduation from a recognized university or college can apply to the PhD program directly. You don't need a PhD degree. Of course, what you do need are the qualifying marks, the eligibility score. If you have that, that means if you meet all the requirements of IIMs, you can directly apply to the PhD program of any of the 20 IIMs. From here, we move on to our fact number 5, which is quite related to our fact number 4. That's CA, CS, ICWA, and even with students who've done an integrated PG course from a recognized institute, of course, you can also apply to the PhD program of IIMs. Yes, again, meet the eligibility requirements, meet the minimum maximum marks requirements. So most of the IIMs have specified what you require in 10th, 12th, your graduation, what are the percentages, and so on. So if you have to meet all these requirements, and then only you can apply to the PhD program. Coming to our next fact. Students from all the streams or any stream can apply to the PhD program of IIMs. Managers are someone who are required in every industry, and that is the reason that students from all stream are welcome to do a PhD from IIMs, and not only management graduates. So whether you are from humanities, from science side, agriculture, medical, engineer, computers, you can apply for a PhD in IIMs. Just ensure that you are meeting the qualifying requirements and the eligibility requirements. Then find a suitable program of a suitable stream that matches your area of interest, your expertise, your knowledge, and apply to that area. So students from all streams can apply for a PhD program in any of the 20. Moving on to our next fact, which is that students who are still pursuing their qualifying degree, whether it's your PG is your qualifying degree or your graduation is your qualifying degree, if you are still in the final year of your qualifying degree, you are pursuing your qualifying degree, you can still apply to the PhD program of IIMs. Throughout the video, we are sharing with you brochures of different IIMs. Here we share with you the brochure of IIMs Calcutta. You can see the eligibility requirements that they've mentioned. You can see the eligibility requirements of IIMs Rohtak. You can see the eligibility requirements of IIMs Trichy. How they've specifically mentioned, you can pause the video and read. This is a screenshot from their own website. You can see how they've mentioned that students who are even pursuing their qualifying degree can apply. Yes, there are certain documents which would be required from your college or from where you are doing your degree, your final qualifying degree. From there, certain special documents would be required. And ultimately, within this time frame which is given to you, you will have to submit your final qualifying degree and you will have to have the required marks which IIMs requires for a PhD. But you, without wasting any time, without wasting a year, you can apply for a PhD program even while you are pursuing your qualifying degree. Now, after this, I'm sharing with you the two most important facts, which I'm sure after hearing those two facts, your entire outlook of this program is going to change. These are the next or the second last fact is that IIMs does not charge a fee for their full-time PhD program. Yes, you heard it right. Most of the students feel that IIMs hai toh the fees would be very high, but that is not true. All the IIMs, and I'm sharing with you another screenshot of another very reputed IIMs. You can see that how they've mentioned that they will not be charging any tuition fee. And this is true for all the 20 IIMs. IIMs does not charge a fee from their full-time PhD scholars. Interesting, right? Now, if you find this fact interesting, then the last one would be even more interesting. IIMs does not charge a fee, and last fact, that it actually gives you a fellowship to pursue a full-time PhD from IIMs. Yes, you get a monthly stipend and a lot of other perks if you are pursuing a full-time PhD from IIMs. Again, all the 20 IIMs do give you this fellowship. Yes, the fellowship amount, the perks do vary from IIMs to IIMs, but all of them give you a fellowship. Sharing with you the brochure of IIMs Bodhgaya, you can see the fellowship that they are giving, the incentives that they are giving you. So that brings us to the end of the video. If you are thinking of doing a PhD, do consider this prestigious institute. It has got a great brand name. It will help you do great research work. It doesn't charge a fee from their full-time scholars and actually pays a fellowship. If you want some more help, some more guidance, some personal guidance, then you can always approach me, contact me for a one-to-one guidance session on all the 20 IIMs, or if you want to know how to go about preparing for IIMs PhD, for anything, I am there to help you to become, I would love to be your coach, your mentor, and your guide in this journey of your PhD. You can contact us on the WhatsApp number given below or the number given in the description box below. This is Dr. Ritika Gauba from Zenith PhD Training and Consultancy, a consultancy which is here to empower you with PhD knowledge. If you've liked our video, if you like the work which we are doing, please do subscribe to our channel, like us and share our videos. Thank you so much for listening to me.